lip service.
All right, y'all. What's good? It's lip service, and we got a fun guest in here with us today. But first, I'm Angela Yee.
I'm Gigi McGuire.
I'm L'Oreal.
Is it my turn?
Yeah.
I'm Kim Osorio.
Kim Osorio is our guest co-host today. You know Kim Osorio as the former editor-in-chief of The Source. She also wrote the book Straight from the Source, which I always talk about. And she was a producer for Love & Hip Hop, but she's moving on and she can't say what she's doing exactly yet. But I'm sure she'll let us know. And Shump is here. Iman Shumpert.
How are you guys?
Otherwise known as Teyana Taylor's husband.
Oh, yeah, for sure. I'm either Iman. I'm Junie's dad, or I'm Teyana's husband.
Those are all good things to be, though.
Yeah, it's cool. It's cool.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
All right, cool. So we're having some fun with you today. You did just put out an EP, though, Substance Abuse, as you abuse substances right now.
But that's what I'm saying. It's the cool thing about it is it's really just a flip on that. It's it's the challenge of trying to take as many good substances as you can and abuse the shit out of those. You know what I mean? And it's like nobody ever talks about that. Like, can you do something good too much?
Like eat too many fruits and vegetables?
Or I eat too much
like
lettuce.
You know what I mean? Can I do too many good things for my family?
No.
You can, though.
Like, what's too many good things?
Like, give them all your money and then be broke.
That's what you're supposed to do.
Kim said that's what you're supposed to do. Kim's going through something right now, just so you know. She's going through a divorce.
But I'm saying that's the question. That's what the project is, to provoke that question.
Right.
Excuse me.
Would you have a...
like, what's worth it? What's not worth it? Like, how do you X certain things out of your life that don't deserve that from you? You
know but it's mean? Interesting because you have a great relationship because you guys both bring a lot to the table.
Yeah.
Right? And you think you would feel crazy if, like, Teyana made way more money than you and she had to take care of you?
It would be awkward.
Why?
Just because with the amount of work that I've done, you know what I mean?
You just said it was a woman's world a couple minutes ago.
He did.
It just so happens that, like, right now, I mean, at some point in time, I'm not going to be playing and she is going to be making more money than me. But if
a lot of men can't handle that. That's what I'm saying.
But that's why it's on that man to get, you have to maximize whatever time you have to maximize. Right. So if I maximize this time and I've made whatever I've made and that's what I'm bringing to the table, and she, because her career and, you know, her different careers, all the avenues she's in, this is stuff that she can do well beyond aging.
Right.
You know what I mean? As long as she keeps up with a certain physical appearance, a lot of the stuff she's doing can be carried on. Right.
But even with the nail salon, because you can have investments and things that you do will carry. Yeah, exactly.
I'm saying, I don't, that's, as a man, the reason why I'm straight is because I'm not, like, I understand the publicized version of what Teyana has going on. Like, she has opened up the doors for everybody to just know everything, and she's very good with that. Like, she's very good with balancing all of those things. Me, on the other hand, I don't do that. Like, I have a lot of businesses and stuff that I'm a part of, but I don't want to, like, you know what I mean? It's hard for me to try and do all this and promote all of these things at the same time. Like, that's hard for me. That's a talent that she has. She can keep all that in her head. I can't do it. She holds a lot of information.
How weird was it for you then to do a TV show?
It was a lot, but it's, like I said, after seeing the end product and seeing that the whole time she was kind of telling me this is how it would go, it made it smoother for me when it came on. You know what I mean? I wasn't as jittery. Like, I gave her a hard time while we was filming it.
You did? It was a good show.
And it was tasteful.
Yeah, but I gave her a hard time.
Anytime you got a cute kid in the mix, you can get away with anything, too.
Yeah. She'd be wild.
Anytime Junie's, she'd be like, look at Junie. It don't even matter anything else. She'd just be like, look at Junie. Now, we saw that Teyana also directed one of your music videos as well from off of the EP.
Yeah. With the aunties.
She found a cool way to put me in the scenery that I wanted to create, because I created a vibe that was to encourage guys to... Because the perception of the strip club is like me and the homies, like, we went out and we were supposed to go to this club, but we went to the strip club after and didn't tell the girls.
Not in Atlanta, right, Gigi?
Hell no. I ain't in Atlanta. It's kind of why we did everything in Atlanta. Mm-hmm. I went to school in Atlanta, so that's kind of where I learned, like, oh, take your girl with you to the strip club. That's where I learned it.
Take your girl with you to every club in the A.
Yeah, that's true.
But that's what I'm saying. That's what, for so long, you know, growing up in Chicago, if we going out, sometimes it's like your girl don't want you around certain stuff. You know what I mean? It ain't like that. So mm-hmm. it's like, you might bust a little play to try and, you know what I mean?
Slide through.
And this is just to encourage the other side of it. Like, even if she don't want to go, make a, you know what I'm saying? Like, if you be transparent about it, it kind of make it to where you could do it. You kind of get away with what you wanted to get away with. Mm-hmm.
You could just have fun together.
Just because you was, yeah, just because you was transparent about it, she ain't tripping.
We were just talking about going to the club in Atlanta. I just thought about a funny Gigi story.
Oh, uh-oh. God.
What happened? We was at the club in Atlanta. Which I don't know if this is your ex or your current boo, because I saw him on your Instagram, but
oh my God, I quit. I like the picture, girl.
Yeah, I did. I like the
y'all
picture too.
Like it and commenting.
She keeps on breaking up and getting back together with her man for what, 9 years now?
Yep.
But anyway, we were in the club one time and Gigi threw up in a cup in the club.
Don't
and
tell then me he drank it.
No.
Oh, I was about to throw up.
And then he drank it, and now he can never leave her.
No. I was like, there's some booty shit about her.
Sure. I was real smooth about it, though.
Fuck the spaghetti. Yeah. Oh, look, nope.
I was like, can I eat my wing without it? But like, then just kept partying.
Yeah, it was like silently, like in the corner.
If I throw up, I gotta go home.
And then I just threw the cup in the trash and, you know, drank some water.
That's crazy.
I was still in the club. Like, I'm okay. You like, you good? You ready to leave? No, girl, we good. Let me just say, no, I'm good now.
Not doing
anything
crazy. So
I thought you was gonna tell a worse story than that. A similar thing happened to me, but I didn't know I was about to throw up. I was,
it just happened.
Yeah, I was drinking, mm-hmm. and it just was like, no, bitch, no more.
That's how it was.
And
with
it
me.
Came right out in the cup.
I wasn't sick before that. We had been out there whole day. Yeah, I wasn't sick before that or nothing. I was like, did you just throw up?
It's too much in the liquor. Cup. Too much liquor. Got to come back up. Substance abuse.
Substance abuse.
And do it
substance
now.
Abuse. Can you do all too right. much partying?
Don DeMarco.
You ever threw up and just kept partying?
No, ma'am. If I throw up, that's it.
Party done.
That's it for me.
That's how I feel. Party's done if I throw up.
You feel better after you throw up.
I
feel
better afterwards. But then you feel like your breath stink, like throw up.
Yeah, you got to wash it.
First of all, Angela, last time I was with her and she threw up, all over her brand new car. Mm-hmm. I'm talking about all
it wasn't that new.
Over. You had just got it like a month or two ago. Mm-hmm.
It wasn't that new.
She threw up everywhere.
Yeah, it was disgusting. Yeah. Mm-hmm. I tried to open the door. I know why I threw up though, because I was actually with my parents. And they were giving us these shots called like birthday cake, and I can't handle milky shots.
Oh, right.
They was good though.
Yeah, and that's why I threw up.
Until
honestly.
She threw them up.
Yeah, I threw them up.
Like, but that, what the stuff. Girls like okay. to drink?
What?
Bailey's.
Oh yeah. Now
lemon
I do
drop.
Lemon drop.
I drink Bailey's in my coffee.
We talking about milk.
I drink Bailey's with milk. Espresso. Yeah. I put a little
lemon drop.
I do like good.
It make it taste better.
Lemon.
When I drink coffee on the plane, I put Bailey's in it.
Yeah, I know what it is. But we talking about a milky drink.
Milky drinks will make me feel sick.
She talking about a milky drink. Pause.
Yeah.
Oh, that was crazy. You see, I had to bring it back. That was crazy.
Now, I was reading about sex dreams, right? And what different sex dreams mean. And like having sex with a different type of person, like a stranger, a coworker, an ex. Like, what does that mean when you have those dreams? Have you ever had a strange dream where you dreamed that you had sex with somebody?
Yes.
And then I'm going to interpret it for you. Go ahead, Gigi. Bob's laughing already
because
he cares of this shit.
Now, I've had a couple of sex dreams, and it's always weird when you feel like he was really doing it. And you wake up and you feel like sex, but it wasn't no sex.
And you like came all over yourself.
I have come in my sleep before.
For real?
Yeah.
That's awesome.
And I woke up like, ooh.
No effort.
What was that?
I did this shit with no effort.
She probably fingered herself in the sleep and didn't realize it.
You know me and my vagina got that whole mental thing going on. So, all right, so what were the strange sex dreams that you had?
I had a dream that I had sex with an ex that I hated.
Oh, let me tell you what that means.
She got the dictionary.
She got the notes. Hold on, sex with an ex. What does that mean? Because that doesn't mean you want to have sex with your ex, by the way. What sex with an ex means is that you need to rekindle the excitement in your intimate life. If you're thinking about an ex who broke your heart, that's a sign that you're stuck emotionally and you have not allowed yourself to move on. So it means you haven't healed and those dreams will continue until you let go.
Or go back.
Or
this is sad.
Just have sex with your ex. Or cry.
Or go back. Or cry.
What about you, Kim? You have sex dreams?
No sex dreams.
Do you dream at all?
I dream a lot.
What do you?
I dream a lot. It's my subconscious. I do that Google crazy. Like,
your dream?
I dream a lot.
What do you dream about? I used to always dream that my teeth were falling out.
That means something like
it means anxiety.
Yeah, teeth. Well, they say teeth is also like a sign of death coming.
Mm. Oh, Jesus.
Yeah. Damn, I ever read that shit nowhere.
But even when someone has a baby, they say that's death or something.
Everything's death.
Everything is death.
No, but I remember the teeth, or it's like either death or a funeral.
And then I also would have the dream where I'm falling, and then I would wake up when I hit the ground.
Oh, yeah, I've had that dream.
I had a dream the other night.
Did you fall?
It was crazy. It was like I was with somebody. We were trying to get into somewhere.
Okay.
And there was an animal coming out of its skin.
Oh.
And when I Googled it, it was talking about like the old relationship. So it was like
shedding your skin.
It was a dream of the new relationship and like you're
like a butterfly.
Yeah. You're scared because your fears are blocking you from going where you want to go. Yeah. My dreams is crazy.
Well, interpret one that I had.
Okay. Let's hear your dream.
Okay. So I had a dream one time that I had.
I have a dream.
I have a dream that one day. Lip service. No, I'm joking.
I had a dream that I had sex with. It was my boyfriend's at the time friend. But this is the craziest thing. I didn't even know him like that.
Oh, let me interpret it.
I didn't like him at all. It wasn't my type. But I woke up like disgusted. Like, but
it happened.
Yeah, why did I fuck him?
It says here that that means you're a hoe.
Nah, sis.
Okay, see, I don't know.
What about if you dream about having sex with somebody that you're not sexually attracted to?
Well, that would wrap it up in both of them, because it's his friend and I wasn't attracted to him, so look him up.
Okay, let's see. Oh, this is different. It don't have none of that. It has sex with a celebrity.
Why does feel like a Cleo?
Sex with a stranger, sex with an ex, sex with your boss. I've never had that dream.
Okay, I want to know what the sex with the celebrity says.
Or a coworker.
What does that say? That means Kim had a dream like that before.
Sex with a celebrity. It means that you're trying to connect with some aspect from that person's movie to improve your life. So think about what first comes to mind regarding the celebrity. Is it a movie?
What if
they're Instagram famous?
Oh my God.
What fucking movie is that?
Yeah, I'm about to say, what if it ain't an actress?
They be more famous than the actress.
Nowadays, right? Mm-hmm. What you think about that?
No, let's talk about your sex dreams, though, first. Do you ever have sex dreams?
I don't really be having a lot of sex dreams, honestly.
He don't want to tell us.
I just don't. And if I do, I really don't remember them. I don't know. A lot of dreams.
You never had a wet dream?
Yeah, not as a grown man, though.
Only when you were younger.
Oh, yeah, when I was
You remember those dreams, though.
For sure, though. But I don't remember them in detail. I just remember what you know what I'm saying, what transpired.
Do guys wake up when they have a wet dream?
I don't, check this out. I done had a wet dream that was like, it felt like Viagra. Like, wet dream, wake up, still up. Go to the bathroom, lean. You ever did the lean over piss? The lean over piss where you like lean on the wall, you try to bid because you man.
He's not talking to us, talking by the way.
No. I'm talking to the guys in the room, man. Listening. Everybody, all of them looking at me like they confused. Like, y'all bogus as hell.
I thought you couldn't pee while you're hard.
Exactly. But that's why you got to lean over and you have to make it to where that you can.
Because then
you
pee in your face.
Exactly. But that's why I said you got to lean over so you can hit the toilet.
You got to lean over.
So
everybody's
it's like
nah.
But it's like, but I'm sorry, I done been like that until I got some that day.
Mm. Like, damn, the whole day?
They stay hard
like, no,
the whole
just
day.
Not even the whole day. Just like until I got what I needed.
What if no one's around? You got to jerk off.
Yeah, just get it out.
Yeah. That's an unfortunate part about going through that when you get older. That's an unfortunate part.
I feel like if you're a guy and you wake up hard, which you are a guy, I feel like you might as well just, if you don't have your wife next to you, you should just jerk off. Why not?
Unless you don't have time.
But how you just gonna walk around with a hard dick?
Okay, let me ask you this. If you have a choice,
it goes away. Oh.
If you have a choice between,
he said all day.
If you have a choice between 10,
that was a specific. That was a specific time.
That was one time. If you have a choice between 10 more minutes of sleep or jerking off, what do you pick?
10 sleep. That's what I'm saying. I don't. Yeah, I got a wife. I don't be. Yeah, 10 minutes. I ain't gotta use my hand. I got a wife.
And I'm saying, if you're alone though, you're on the road.
Yeah, but I'm saying that how long I'm on the road. I ain't on the road for
No, let's just say you wake up and you're like, I could either get out of bed or I could
get one
myself.
Off real quick.
Yeah. I could go back to
I'm
sleep for 10 more minutes.
I'm not a type of guy. I'm not.
Do you consider yourself a sex symbol?
Oh, for sure.
So I heard Teyana call you that on the show a few times.
For sure. Mm-hmm.
Is that her idea or yours?
Both. I think we both recognize her.
Who
more jealous? Because obviously guys love Teyana and just like women love you. Yeah. Who's more jealous? Like who's
of what?
Like
of the sex simplicity.
Like have you ever
sex
have you ever been nervous that maybe like
for sure, though. It's she's
been
already.
She's been around somebody and you're like, damn, I'm kind of like, what are you doing? Like extra calling and texting.
What do you mean?
Like, you know, she's not around and you know she's working, but you know there's a lot of dudes around. You get a little bit, like, insecure.
Nah, with the acting. I mean, the acting's a little weird. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? And I'm going to have to get, whether I like it or not, I got to get ready, prepared for that. But it's like, besides that, we're good.
So sex scenes are okay?
It's just part of what is she want to, you know what I mean? Like, mm-hmm. That's part of their shit.
Can you watch it?
Yeah, do you have to be there?
I don't know. I ain't had to watch it yet. I don't know. Can I watch it?
You look uncomfortable right now.
Yeah, he's like, ah. Because I keep it a bean. It ain't something I can't laugh about it because I'll later on be hype. You know what I'm saying? Like, I don't know. I don't know how I feel about it. So I just try and stay neutral and understand that she, you know, she trying to do her career. They get a window of time where they could do this, let her rock out. Like,
do you guys come to you for like relationship advice because they see
yeah,
your
but I be telling them, like, I'm failing half the time too. Half the time she mad at me too. Shit.
Okay, let's talk about that.
Yeah, she gonna be mad at me
because just recently you somehow ended up in the middle of this Drake.
They always do that situation. That's cool. I get clicks. That mean I'm a sex symbol. But that's what that mean. Like,
here's the thing: when this whole situation happened, did you give Teyana a heads up? Like, just so you know, before I met you.
No, that's what I'm saying. Before any of this, like I've been had to give Teyana this list.
Because you can't have her walk in a room.
She can't feel embarrassed.
She has to
ever.
Know that I had the same conversation.
She can't be embarrassed. I ain't gonna have her be embarrassed.
Yeah. Yeah. What's crazy though is that Kim,
you need the list.
In her book, she had to talk about certain people that she had been with, and you got with your
soon-to-be ex-husband
after that.
Yeah, well, he encouraged me to write about it. Mm-hmm. But he don't even have the list like that. It's people that he don't know about.
Mm. Shit. Whoop. Do you leave people out? So yes, you leave people out. Okay.
You absolutely leave people out. But no, not if you...
not if...
This is an issue, G.
No. I respect the list. I had this conversation recently
with... leave people out.
In this new relationship, I haven't. I'm like comfortable. I'm like, let me tell you what it is.
Wait, you have a new relationship?
Because... Yeah, but because
you still married.
You gotta move on, though. He moved on first. What is he saying? No, what the list is important.
You want to leave the world?
I love the list, but you have to put the list out there because you cannot have her walk in a room and not be in the know. You understand what I'm saying?
Yeah, that's
so
what I'm saying.
I agree with that. And I think with a guy too, like, tell me, don't have me walking in a room and there's some chicken there that you smashed and I don't know.
But Kim, you said you didn't give up all your names.
This is the balance though.
I didn't, but that's because we didn't establish that.
But that's what I'm saying.
This is the list.
I'm sure that women is a little different because
some people don't count.
Yeah, for y'all, that's what I'm saying. Women is very, first of all, strategic and all that, and it's going to be a secret, and it's weird, whatever.
Weird.
With dudes, it's just like dogs. Like, a dog going to doo-doo right in the middle of the floor. A cat finna go behind somewhere, put something over it, cover it up. Like, that's it's true. Just natural, G. Like, yeah, a dude is cool with saying it to your face, but the moment he see it hurt you, he might pull. That'll make him pull back. Because I said this, and now you look so hurt, and now you acting weird, so maybe I shouldn't tell you in the future. That's what a dude thinking.
But I'm telling you,
when it become an open dialogue early, like she said, as long as it's done early, and the dude has to do a good job of telling her, all right then, but if it's too much, you got to let me know. I don't want to be playing off of your looks and shit.
Right.
I don't want you sad. So if it's going to mess up the rest of the day, I ain't going to say it.
But somebody like that chick, Sophie, like, you would never think that would come up.
I wouldn't have mentioned her.
That's what I'm saying.
She wouldn't have been on that list because you're not thinking like y'all going to be in a room together.
Listen, it's a conversation that I'm an athlete. Yeah. Right.
Oh Lord.
No, for real. This is what it is.
And you know what comes with that.
It's not even that. No. I wasn't saying it like that. I mean, we're more accessible. We're more.
Are you?
Yeah. Are we not?
I don't know.
Why do you say accessible?
You have more options is what you mean. You have more options.
Yeah.
No,
yeah.
I mean this. We play ball in New York, right? We going out tonight. We hit the promoters. What's the hot club tonight? Cool. This the one everybody going to be at. All the girls is going to this one, right?
Well, y'all going looking for the girls.
It's four of us, and we all get our own table. Who you think going to get the most attention there? You see what I'm saying?
The promoter?
No. You see what I'm saying? The promoter be trying to sit.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Keeping it a bean. I'm just saying, like, they can get to us. If you look good enough, you could get to us. You see what I'm saying? And it's one of them things that is... all of us, you know what I'm saying? Especially if you didn't have a girl. Like I told my girl, I said, listen, you realize that you could have saved me all this because I came up on you in 2011.
But you probably weren't ready.
I probably wasn't. But yeah, you could have molded me.
It's the time, though.
You'd have dropped a lot of bodies. It wouldn't have been no, you know what I'm saying? Like, you could have saved me some headaches.
You probably had to go through what you had to
put me together like, she could have been, you going to stay your ass home today. And I'd have saved my ass.
Yeah, but you might not have been ready for that. You were very young and still out and about.
I don't know what I wanted. I don't know if I was ready for a kid. Popped out, I'm ready. You see what I'm saying? Like, that's
but
what I'm
saying. I feel like timing is important too, though.
We'll find out. And maybe it worked out for the better. I needed to live this out. Mm-hmm. Maybe I needed to. Mm-hmm. I don't know. Whatever. Everything's worked out perfectly. You know what I'm saying?
But the point is, I'm sure certain people, like that chick, Sophie, whatever, you probably didn't feel like you would ever run into her. So that's something.
No, for sure. But that's what I'm saying. But it's a conversation that's not hard to have with my wife. Right. Because we don't.
She's like, it's before you.
Yeah.
But did you tell her, like, after the Pusha T this? Like, oh, shit, this bitch might be coming to light. No. Or did you have the conversation?
It ain't even one of them things. It was like, I don't know. It's hard to explain. I don't remember. I remember having a conversation.
As long as it's not your baby, we good.
Yeah, I remember having a conversation.
He ain't on the list.
That's what I'm saying. I wouldn't think that you would put her on the list.
I don't think any of us are really involved in this list. This person had 300 followers, whoever this was, with a fake picture. Right. He was trolling people all day. He randomly puts a tweet up saying something about Drake's BM, got no hits, deletes that tweet and puts up the tweet saying Iman Shumpert, James Harden, ASAP Rocky. It turns into like 8,000 interactions as far as retweets and likes. And now people is hitting me up and Teyana like, dog, can you clear the air? Like, that's
right.
I get it that you be on your, we are above this rumor thing, but that's hella rumors and you haven't said nothing. Can you please just say something? Mm-hmm. Like, right. That's how I got it. That was the conversation. It wasn't like a conversation like, yo, did you, when was this?
But she already knew.
She know. Like.
See, the only reason why this is bothering me.
That's why I'm going to get this off. No, I'm going to get this off why it really be bothering me, right? I got to say this correctly.
Talk your shit.
Because I'm hype. I want the public to start like clicking on these stories and these rumors and things, right? And you got to check my track record. I don't know how you can do that. You got to ask around.
How can you do that?
You got to ask around or something. You know what I'm saying? But you can't look at my wife and then think that what is reported is real. You can't.
Right.
I don't feel like you can do that. You can't look at all the things we involved in, everything we got our hands in, and then think that. Especially when it's stuff like, it be stuff happening. Like the whole, I hate to bring it up. But my man that played, my man that's still playing right now.
Tristan.
He got in his little incident. I got dragged into it by a person that was not involved in the incident. Mm-hmm. And nobody said nothing about it. Everybody was acting like it was real. I was like, bro, so do I have this moment where I give this glow head glow? And do I say something like, no, this person, I don't know this person. And then y'all all go click on her and then maybe y'all like her. So y'all follow her and now she get attention.
Right.
Because that's all they went for. They start promoting models on that page that everybody clicked on. Mm-hmm. I'm like, so, but y'all just added a body to my name that don't exist. And then y'all wondering why my wife ain't killed me yet. But it'd be like I'd be daring the public to just like, dog, just read it. Like, she wasn't even the one Tristan walked in with. Right. It wasn't even her. Like, how I get dragged into this? But it's like, if I come down and be like, yo, like, especially with me being hurt. I was hurt. I wasn't playing at the moment. It was like, I can't get involved in all these little games, which I want to.
I can't bicker and go on the internet and kill, diminish my wife brand and everybody brand. Right. Like, oh, he fighting with fans and he talking with this. So I can't, you can't just get access to me, baby. You got to have some real juice.
But at the same time, you promoting your music. So yeah, you're paying attention to what everybody's saying.
Yeah. Here and there, I'll see the shit. That's what I'm saying. Or it'll get
and sometimes
enough.
You're in the wrong moment and you be like,
yeah. You'll have a moment where you whatever. But it's like, I can't constantly do that with people.
Did Tristan ever ask you for advice?
No. That man's straight, man.
Because look, from the outside as we look in, looks like a great relationship from what we've seen.
And that's what y'all got to understand, too. And what we know, telling people all the time, we in a real relationship that got real. You got problems in your relationship, we got problems in ours.
Right.
We just take pictures that more people get to see.
Mm-hmm.
So we put a couple pictures up and videos up. Yeah, we smiling just like everybody else do on their page.
Matching outfits is cute.
Matching outfits.
Yeah, we gonna have. Now, don't get me wrong. Our highs is high.
You wear clothes like, by accident.
Yeah, it's highs and lows and shit, and we got high highs. I ain't gonna. You know what I'm saying? But it's like we got times that we mad at each other. We got times that we. You know what I mean? We get into it. We got moments.
It's very fun to make up when you guys are mad at each other. When y'all make up.
Yeah. Smell the headboard with her makeup. Good song. Love her.
Yeah. I watched the video.
So, wait,
how does it work with the videos, though? So, like, what if... Because I know she's been in a lot of your videos.
Love her video. She shot her own.
Yeah, I see. You wasn't in that at all.
No, she was just bored. It might have been just a surprise for me or something. I know I wasn't around her for a while. And she just randomly just sent it to me.
And then the other one, she's obviously the main girl. So, like, every time you do a video, you're going to make sure it's you and her in the video? Is that a rule?
I wanted to, but that'd be extremely difficult. She works too much.
Right. Even the video that she directed, she has other girls in it and everything. So,
She's in the car with him, though.
Right.
Yeah, like
let's keep it real.
Let's be clear.
Mm-hmm. I'm
those
in the
bitches
car.
Is on the stage.
And I'm by his side. She encourages my sex simplicity.
Sex and bliss.
Now I want to ask you about other people now and what's going on in social media and get your just general opinion of this. Okay. So this one woman did a whole post about how she was supposed to fly out and meet up with Future. I don't know. Did you see this story? Now she did a whole post about how they had been
saying a whole post or a
talking
whole
with
post.
Each other.
Oh. Whole post.
And she was in the studio with him and he was cool and nice. And then he said he wanted her to fly out and come see him. So she agreed. He said for her to book her own flight and he would pay her back for it. And then she got out there and he told her to be waiting on him in the room with lingerie. That's when she said, lingerie wasn't on my mind when I was packing. I was thinking more of the studio because she's an artist. And she said, but anyway, I told him I wasn't on that type of time. We talk, but we don't talk enough for me to fuck him. So she said when she went back to her room, her key didn't work. So she thought she put her phone too close to the key, deactivated it. Turns out that he actually only had the room booked for that one night, didn't reimburse her for her flight, and didn't pay for the room after that. Do you think that if a guy, now if one of your teammates or one of your boys were to ask you, if a guy flies you out, does that mean that that's with the understanding that something's about to go down?
Listen, I don't know.
And this is in general, not about this particular situation.
That's what I'm saying. I would need more information.
Okay, but I'm just saying, say a guy flies a girl out.
They hung out before, too.
They hung in the studio, though, and never did anything. Just in, and, she's an, and she's an artist. Because, L'Oreal, you're an artist.
Okay. So, I'm not flying to go see no nigga, though, and staying in no room.
I don't even know if knowing that she's an artist, how I know she ain't just whipped this up so that we could talk about her and check on her music.
Well, not only that, I feel like she should have known what she was getting herself involved in. He's a rapper, for Christ's sake.
Even if Christ's sake,
and got five baby mamas.
Nah, but that's not cool, though.
Iman's a rapper.
That's
he don't
cool.
got five baby mamas.
No, what I'm
so
trying
what,
to say
what that
is...
man, what that man got going on with his whatever, man, as long as he take care of his kids, that ain't nobody understanding but his and his BMs. Bro.
No, but if they were chilling and talking and he asked her to fly out,
I feel like he was
willing to get her room and all of that, like if you're flying out with somebody, then you should
already know that they might expect something. So if you plan on not going that way, then either don't go or make sure that before you go, y'all have a clear understanding of what's going on. If y'all, if you going thinking it's all business, exactly, that's what I'm trying to say. If you going before you, if you know before you go that you wanted to stay on the business lane, then you need to let him know before I come, before you go, like, okay, well, it's going to stay business.
But well, what is it, the business, or was it just like, if they're hanging out?
Was she only mad because she didn't pack the lingerie?
Technically, is that prostitution? It's like, okay, I'm flying you out, then so I'm paying you. You know what I'm saying? So you have to fly and fuck me.
Well, I don't know.
That's like, oh, I'm just saying. I'm just saying.
But that's also saying a date is prostitution.
Yeah, so that's what I'm saying. You can't expect her to have to lay down with this man. You can't expect that just because he's flying her out.
This is all alleged.
He said pay.
But we're just dealing with if her story's true. What do you think about
it? They can expect it, but that's crazy.
But he told her pay for her flight and he'll
reimburse her.
He'll reimburse her. That's it. That's the deal. That's the deal. If y'all have an oral contract, right? If you have an oral contract,
allegedly,
and I'm gonna pay you, right? I'm gonna give you the money back, whatever it is, right? And there's no understanding there. There's no communication. This is the law school coming in. There's no communication about we got to do it, whatever it is, right? Then you can't expect that. There's no expectation there.
The only expectation is I'm getting on the plane. The
and
only
that's
way she
it.
Messed
when
up was buying her own flight.
You that's where she fucked up because money ain't guaranteed unless it's in
exactly.
a hand.
No, and I wouldn't have went. The minute he said, buy my flight and I'm going to burst you, I'd be like, never mind.
I don't, you can't fuck with a nigga like that.
I mean, she's still, I guess her stuff was in the room. She has to get it out.
She lying.
He said, "What did he do?"
Now she said her room was locked.
She
deactivated.
Yeah, they deactivated the key.
Stuff was still in the room. Wait, it's time to check out, bitch. It's over.
Right.
So, but so already done. Her get her but stuff. She said she got another room in the same hotel.
But say she fucked the shit out of him that day, right? He might have brung it to the hotel he was staying at. Maybe that's why he only had it for one day. You don't motherfucking know what his situation.
Or maybe
was.
He was only planning to have her there for one day, and then that was it.
Or
that's
maybe
what she said.
His friend was supposed to fuck her. I don't fucking know.
Damn.
What? I don't know.
It's turning to a gangbang on your party.
Or maybe she wasn't supposed to fuck at all. Maybe, this is what I'm saying. Is
maybe
that crazy?
She lying.
Or maybe she's
like
lying.
But she
maybe she just wants some attention. Because why? What's the point of telling the story in the first
That's
place?
That's what I'm trying to
what's the? You think you putting
she
him on blast, but you putting yourself.
She want her $500.
But she think she putting him on blast. She putting her on blast. She putting herself on blast.
So you told this story for $500 back.
That's what she said.
And attention. Yes.
She said she want her money back. But you think attention. Now that you told the story that you
want hey, your money me, back, you really ain't so gonna get your money back. I've seen so many plays made that I can't believe these days, though.
I'm sure. No, but one thing I will say, if she's been around this nigga before numerous times and
she
they didn't
once.
Have sex.
In the studio.
Never mind.
Again, she's an artist, so they're supposed to be working.
Who is this artist?
Nobody heard her.
She's not loving hip hop.
She's an aspiring artist, damn it.
No, I'm saying. Yeah.
We don't know her.
We never heard her
anonymous on this?
No. She has her page up. People are following her, and a lot of guys are trying to shoot their shot now because she's still there.
I've seen the pictures.
Can she rap, though?
I don't know. I think she's a singer.
So you didn't click on her?
No, I didn't. I didn't have time. It just happened.
Clickbait.
Now, we were reading about this study, right? They said that people who have a better sense of smell have better sex and actually have more orgasms.
People have what?
A better sense of smell. And you know, they always say that your sense of smell is very related to your attraction to somebody, too.
Mm-hmm. I agree.
Oh, yeah. My wife's scent, I know it.
Yeah, I agree with
For
that.
For sure, though. For sure, though. If I'm sitting there like this and she won't waking me up, I know it.
It
I know
better
my
be
mama.
Her.
I only know... I probably only know like 4 or 5 cents.
So
like,
you think you have an advanced sense of
which
smell?
Which means like you can't fuck.
Oh, man. Damn.
Did you not hear what she just said?
Well, moving on.
He said he only smelled 5 things in his life.
No.
That's not what he said, Maria.
That's crazy.
She's silly.
That's the funniest joke y'all heard all day on that. Team L'Oreal. L'Oreal shampoo ass nigga.
So you don't have a good sense of smell?
No, I have a very good sense of smell. I'm saying I could pick out 5 cents.
I caught you.
See what I'm saying? Like in a crowd full of people, like if my mother-in-law walked past a crowd full of people, I know it's her.
Mm-hmm.
I could be blind and I could know. I could pick her out. I could pick my mother out. I could pick Teyana out. I could pick Junie out. I could probably pick both my grandmothers out too.
All right.
But it's like I could like right now like
go to my grandmother's house as far as the smell. I could smell it right now.
How about any of your teammates? Like, you ever been like, oh,
you know what I mean? But you know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying?
Like, he was in some
it's
bad
like
pussy.
A smell.
What happened?
Like, you ever had a teammate that smelled like this nigga breath smelled bad?
Oh, yeah, yeah. He smelled like last night.
Yeah.
For sure.
Like, oh, my he was in some bad pussy.
For sure. He smelled like he had a bad batch. For sure. You talk that away.
Do you tell him that though?
Or
you
just sure.
As a friend, like, yo.
I don't lie. I'm not a good liar. I'm actually a terrible one.
That's funny.
I'm actually really bad.
Have you ever had to deal with somebody that smelled bad?
All the time.
How that?
Just people you work with, you know, like there was one person I remember, his breath was just horrible. And I talk on the same receiver.
Oh my God. That happens in the studio all the time.
Back when we didn't have all of this and we just had the like phone in the office. And you pick up the phone after someone,
it smells like saliva.
Oh. Yeah, I've had
that's
that.
That's the worst. That happened in the studio.
Toothpaste at the source. We used to leave toothpaste on people's desks.
Damn. I think you used to throw it away, clearly, because
somebody left some toothpaste.
I was on a plane the other day, sitting next to this man that smelled so bad. Like, he drank that whole big ass bottle of Belvedere straight, and then it just was all sweating out of his pores. He wasn't even talking. And just from him sitting next to me, it was the worst three and a half hour flight. It was worse than babies crying. I would have listened to babies crying over having to smell this man. It smelled so disgusting.
I'll never forget getting off a flight and brushing my teeth after a red eye. So I'm brushing my teeth. And I guess dude had to go. I don't know.
Shit smell while you brushing your teeth?
No.
Oh, I thought you said go.
Right.
I was in the bathroom first. I'm brushing my teeth.
Thank God.
And the man rushing me, I say, I'm brushing my teeth. The man say, it don't take that long to brush my teeth. I say, I know your breath's there. I know yours. I know yours is bogus. I know everything in there is just bad. It's hot. I know it. Cause I ain't been in here that long though.
Yeah. You gotta get
you know what I mean? I'm doing my thing right now. Yeah, I gotta, you know what I mean?
He had the bubble guts. He had to go.
But he wasn't trying to wait.
His quote wasn't, I have to go. Can you speed it up?
He said it don't take that long.
He said it doesn't take that long. Like, yes, it does, bro.
I got to brush my tongue.
Actually, it does.
I got to brush my teeth.
Yeah, you got a lot that you have to do in there. Yeah. No nasty.
You
like,
got to touch every single one.
And you got to use mouthwash. It's a process, bro. You can't just.
Yeah, the back seat.
It ain't an
really
in and out situation.
Get behind them.
It ain't an in and out situation.
There's some people that talk and you could just tell they're not.
They don't get in behind.
They still got yesterday's meal back there.
Yes. Or they missed. Missing a whole five teeth on the side.
If you're missing a tooth, you really got to dig that out of there. You got to get that out of the crater. You do. You have to do these things, though, that people forget. Just never have that quote leave. Anybody listening to this podcast, I just never have that quote leave out for you. It doesn't take that long. Don't say nothing like that when you see somebody brushing their teeth, Joe. It's okay.
As long as they need.
Yeah, let them do their thing, man. Dang.
Me and Angie knew someone.
We knew a few people.
We were trying to figure out how to tell them, though. And neither one of us, that was some punk shit. Neither one of us wanted to tell them.
You didn't want
to
say anything.
You
didn't
tell somebody their breath stinks.
Yeah, you were one of the most disrespectful.
No, you put that, give them gum.
What? She talking about somebody else. Something else.
But I'm saying you be around it. Like, you should have some asshole in you now.
Well, I have had to tell somebody before that he stank. I have. He used to work with us when I was at Sirius. Mm-hmm. And he came in and I made a joke. I was like, yeah, he's here. You smell me? I was like, actually, the reason why I made that joke is because we've been talking about you don't smell that good.
Wow.
You don't smell that good. Yeah.
See,
that was honest.
That's messed up.
I mean, I had to tell him.
Or there's a motherly nurturing way you could do it. You buy person stuff. Like, you buy
them.
I
smell
you.
He should have reported you for bullying.
I've done something like that.
Bullying is being honest.
That's bullying.
That is a bully.
Because if Bill Cosby said that, that's bullying.
No, it's not.
I agree.
It is. And it might be harassment.
I didn't touch him.
It might be harassment. It might be harassment.
I didn't touch
just
him.
Just because you didn't like my
him.
Fragrance. Just because you don't like my fragrance.
What if I would have drugged him and made him take a shower?
He ain't drugging people.
Sometimes people smell because it's their clothes. Like, it's
right.
They might shower and put on the same dirty, funky clothes. And I think that's what he was doing. Because you know how people have like a ring around.
No.
No. That should not have a ring around anywhere like on your body or your clothing.
And people be wearing like old dirty clothes.
That's like
clothes.
Old Flintstones. How'd you get the ring out of the neck?
Yeah. How'd you get the dirty ring out of the neck?
That's disgusting.
Have you ever had a stalker?
Yeah.
Ooh.
Like, you've had a few. Mm. Was it like anything that was ever bad enough that you actually had to like do a police report?
Yeah.
Wow.
That's crazy.
Was it a man or a woman?
A woman.
I mean, it could be men stalking you too, because people are super fans.
That's gotta, that's what I'm saying. But as a dude, though, if you was to stalk me, like, but I'm already gonna be, as a dude, from where I'm from and being around my friends that have done some terrible things, I always feel like somebody's trying to make a play. Even if I can't, I feel like I see it and I'm not gonna ignore that I see that, but you doing something that makes me feel like you about to do something slick and I don't got time. So I'm gonna handle you before, you know what I mean? So if you're a stalker, if I identify you as a stalker, now it's just like, if you're in a room, I have to go over there and I have to handle this now.
You have to confront the stalker?
Because I can't, if it's a dude, feel like you.
Are there ever dudes that are like clingers on stalkers?
I've had instead of a stalker and anything, the most annoying thing about dudes is when
you have a table in the club
anywhere I'm at
and they're holding and your bottles
and they they constantly everything they say they dap. So it's like you come up, you say what's up, cool, we cool, and then it's like, yeah, my
mad
nigga
daps.
And then it'd be like, hey, you see, I seen him in it's like, and I'll tell him after, I'll be like, bro, we dapped already. But it'd be even some friends.
It was
friends.
Too natural for him to keep on dapping just now.
His hand was already up in the position.
That was too natural.
That was a joke. These are jokes.
But get too close. I don't like when people get
Yeah,
on
it's one of them things like, yeah, I don't like people doing that. So I'm going to give you the arm bar. And then after a while, if it get out of hand or I feel like I'm going to answer in a rude way, like, and it's going to go to the next level, I'm going to ask my brother or I'm going to ask somebody, hey, bro, I don't know why he keep dapping. I usually be trouble, though. I don't know why he keep dapping me, bro. You don't know him? I don't know
this
him.
This guy
like
is
that,
dap
bro.
Happy.
No, I mean, because it's also one of them things where.
Dappy freestyle.
Yo, the fuck?
You going down that road? Because, man, that's a road, man. Ooh, if you know, you know. Straight up.
But what about women? How do you handle when you have women stalkers?
Sex simplicity. It just comes with the territory, man.
But sometimes it's a little too much.
You know what it is, though? I don't have women stalkers that's like a red alert. I've never had, not like with my family now and everything. I think women, I mean, despite what rumors and bullshit goes on so people can get their clicks.
Mm-hmm. Like you had a secret phone, remember that one?
Yeah, and me and Teyana was breaking up because the show was 6 episodes or something. They changed producers
three. Was it an Android or an iPhone?
Asshole. You know I'm Android now. My iPhone got hacked so many times, and then it got to the point where you ever had Apple call you?
Yeah.
It showed up as Apple Inc. So I trusted it. So they asking me for my serial number.
You gave them all.
Oh my God.
They said they had entered me into the highest security.
You think it's like a senior citizen.
Gee, it said Apple Inc.
It said, I'm in Nigeria. I've lost all my luggage.
Listen though. Have y'all
send me a green dot card?
I need you to wire some money.
Oh, so I'm dumb. Oh, so now I'm dumb.
Go outside right now. Go to Walgreens. Get a gift card. Put as much money as you have in your account.
We want to leave it to us.
And send it to this address.
We need to wire you $2 million to your bank account. We just need your information.
Yeah, they got you.
Yeah,
they got
by the way.
Apple Inc.
He said. It's okay. Play as fuck up.
I am too. That was funny.
You mess up my makeup.
I'm really legit. You gonna laugh like that too? God damn. No.
I legit fucked that shit up.
No, but
so go ahead, Grandpa.
Okay, so. So look, it's Apple Inc., but I've been getting hacked for so long.
Karen, you know Karen Civil.
Yes, you had to Karen, interrupt to get
Karen,
you.
So Karen got my, she got recovered everything from mm-hmm. me, right? So her and Teyana made all my, they was like, you be putting easy passwords. That's right. Why anybody can
lie. Judy won.
Iman went
My shit Teyana. Was that simple because I had so many passwords for different things. Teyana. I couldn't remember anything. So I'm like, dog, I got to have something. You know what I'm saying? So I had something real simple.
One, and two,
Sacramento.
Three, four.
Whatever, something real cool. And Teyana and them, you know, they juice it
high
up.
High tops.
You know, they juice it up, make everything hella one. Numbers, underscores, all right. type of weird.
You bull. Can't even remember it.
No, I done wrote everything down and keep it on me in my wallet. You see what I'm saying? So I got all my passwords.
Hey, I know.
Let me
nah, that, see, that was the okie doke for him.
I put it
that
in my
phone. That was the okie doke for him. That was the okie doke. That was the okie doke.
Somebody pickpocketed
him.
And
no, 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 no. I really had it in my phone. Okay. But I didn't want to say that because
so that way if someone breaks into
yeah,
your phone,
somebody want to steal my phone. That's anyway. What I'm saying. That's why they already own me. So I was like, maybe I should say this on a piece of paper. I ain't worried about nobody taking my wallet, Gloria.
Yeah, what shit. Right.
Don't come over here robbing for wallets.
Get his wallet right now.
Don't do none of that, dog. No.
Get that password.
So no, man. No, no. But it was. So once I had all dog. Them, I had all them passwords and everything.
She's still laughing.
They like never stopped. They like kept going at it to where I was getting emails where people were saying they shut down my Apple ID because somebody had put the wrong password. Mm. And they was like, it's somebody in Texas.
Click this link.
So they telling me. They,
call us here.
But they sending me all this. Yeah, they telling me to call who out the band. But they emailing me. It looked funny. I'm not rocking with it. You know what I'm saying? So I ain't paid it
no
attention.
And it was really done that time.
I ain't paid it. I don't know, though. That's what I'm saying. To this day, I don't know. So I talked to them. And when I talked to them, I asked for the associate that helped me out before. I'm like, I just talked to you for an hour. And he was, because I asked
like,
for,
is Akbar there?
But listen, I remember the employee being, it was a distinct name. It wasn't a name. Sure. So whoever the scammer was, either the scammer really talked to Buddy and knew Buddy was on the line and that I would ask for him and get him.
They gave you back to him?
He was like, I didn't talk to you, sir.
Oh.
But he sounded the same and everything. So I'm like, all right, well, one of y'all, somebody lying.
Right. Damn.
So now I'm reporting to Apple. I'm doing all this stuff. I'm thinking I got clout. I don't. Right. They, you know what I mean? They just wasn't Apple, taking. They wasn't taking yet. Me serious enough. Said, like, okay, if we lose you, we got plenty others. Right. Like, they paying
so
for the
now
phones,
I have an
brother.
Android.
So basically, I was like, dog, I'm not. If y'all can't explain this to me, if I'm coming into the Apple store, y'all want to take pictures, talk about my wife and my kid, do all this stuff, and y'all can't. Me. Fix this?
Right. Then I'm out.
I'm up. Like, I come in here and spend too much money. I'm up. Like,
yeah, I get good service. Man.
And I told all my mom, I told everybody, hey, man, download Duo. Y'all can still FaceTime me. Still got good quality, brother. We still got quality out here.
What I is in this... his phone that they was on him like that?
Come on. They trying to get her nudes, man. I know what they want.
You have nudes in your phone?
Huh? I'm up.
If you got high, you can hear it, nigga. He does.
I have that stuff.
I know.
You
have
it's stuff like, videos. you know, if Junie and Tiana take a bath together, it's like pictures for the house.
Mm-hmm. Sure. Yeah, I can tell by your whole new voice that wasn't true.
Yeah, you know.
We don't need any more scandal from you.
That's what I'm saying. Why do people act like my shit is so interesting that they need to break into my shit?
They want to see.
Now, let's talk about your song, Critical.
That's what I'm saying. Why they so critical of me?
Mm-hmm. It felt like you really was in your feelings though on that song.
So it's one of them songs like I always try and find like pockets in music that what is timeless for people, right? And what I found was that with women especially, like when I just watch their reaction in the club and singing a song, like if they hear a song that it's a story about a different girl, yeah, they gonna sing it. But when it says like me, you type of vibe mm-hmm. where they feel like the song is the person speaking to them. And when they sing it out, they're speaking to somebody that doesn't have to be physically here right now. Mm-hmm. I feel like that's what take it up a notch and make it timeless.
Gotcha.
So what I made critical, it was more so making like a dude that basically did a little too much. No, he did a little too much, but he like, you know, even my too much ain't in the foul play.
Was this about you?
Yeah, this is like this is me. This is basically me just talking shit to my wife. Like, mm-hmm. you know, yeah, I'm going to do shit that's going to blow you. Like, yeah.
And
like,
she going to do shit too.
Yeah, mm-hmm. You going to do shit that's going to blow me. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, if we really
as
together.
As long as we blow each other, we're good.
As long as you blow me when you get home.
That's crazy. Yeah, but I mean, like, you know what I mean? Like, you're going to have moments where you disagree with how somebody carrying this for, it's going to be for 30 seconds, though. Mm-hmm. I'm a 30 seconds. Oh, man, oh, I'm jealous. Whatever. We'll laugh about that shit when we get home. Whatever. But it was basically taking that and blowing the situation up and then making it to where I'm more in a confident control of the argument type of thing. Like, I know how I could just move you over type of thing. So it's like a begging type of vibe on the chorus, but it's really to be like, I know that you know that you fucking with me. Like, so we
straight.
It's okay,
straight. To, be- it's okay like, to
I know,
beg it,
I know
wife.
We mad for this. You know, we mad, but we good.
We good.
That's what critical is.
Do you give in more, like, as far as in the relationship, when y'all get in an argument, are you the one to be like, all right,
yeah, I don't think any dude wins. I don't think any dude wins, bro. We don't win.
As long as you know that going into it.
Whatever. But it's like, I don't, she's fair, though, a mm-hmm. little bit. Kinda sometimes.
A little bit kinda mm-hmm. sometimes.
I seen her explode on you in one of the episodes and then you came back
with the flowers.
And you brought the flowers. That was very sweet of you.
Yeah. It's
she seemed a little stressed about what she was going through.
Yeah, but that's another thing. That's what was weird about the whole footage thing and how they had six episodes.
Edited and everything.
They edited it. They kinda took out a whole part where me and Teyana really got into it about Junie playing with the glass jars.
So that's why she said, I'm not your kid. I was like, well, where did that come from? But exactly. You're not editing it.
So Junie took the glass jars and was banging them together. And I came down on Junie hard about it. Mm-hmm. But I was doing it more. So I'm like, I'd rather her jump when she hear my voice get loud
than
to bow and slice her hand open. And we going back to the hospital because mm-hmm. we just went for her eating that baby rash mm-hmm. stuff. Mm-hmm. And we panicking. We don't know what's going on. All I read on the back is if consumed by a child, yeah, take straight to a physician. Mm-hmm. Oh, whoa, are we up? Stop the cameras, G, we out. But it's like, if I could prevent her from going to the hospital, that's what I'm trying to do. I don't want my baby having a scar on her hand mm-hmm. that she had to learn because I'm trying to let her be carefree. Like, no, I made that mistake for you. I got plenty scars. I did that for you, baby. Ain't nothing good coming mm-hmm. from that. I probably delivered it to her wrong because I wasn't ready for her to be banging it how she was. She mm-hmm. was, psh, psh, I'm, oh, whoa, put that down. Smack her hand. Psh, right. Put that down.
You
man.
Were scared for her.
Yeah, mm-hmm. I tweaked. But it was like, yeah, I probably handled it wrong, whatever. And, you know, me and T was just having a parenting argument. Mm-hmm. Like, she like, you don't have to do that and tell her no all the time. And I'm like, listen, if I got to tell her no to prevent the hospital, that's what I'm doing. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Like you was doing your hair. You wasn't even paying her no mind what she had going on, G. Like, just stay over there and get your hair done. That's how, you know what I mean? She was just like, you ain't finna talk down on me. That's how she came. So it kind of made her look crazy and it made me look like the savior, but we had really
It did look like that.
But I'm not finna juice
y'all.
Yeah, I'm not finna juice y'all up like that. She don't just
I
only say that because it's like, I get it. Like, girls be like, oh, Teyana just be going crazy. Like, dog, y'all not finna make her seem psycho.
That's what they made it look like.
Then that's why they were like, Iman had to tweet it out.
And they made it seem like, she was that scared she wasn't gonna win the award and everything. And it was like, I get what y'all playing in. Too,
right.
Ain't it?
Let's keep it a bang.
Kim, how important is it as parents to make sure that you guys are on the same wavelength when it comes to the kids?
You ain't never gonna be all the way on.
That mm-hmm. was the whole thing. What was one of the major things in my marriage? We couldn't co-parent. We didn't agree on things. You
really?
Know? Yeah, we didn't agree on
like
how to.
What?
Like, I didn't agree. I will spank my kids if they do something like that. Your hand touched the fire. You hit your hand. You know, so you know, oh my God, that's gonna hurt. But he spanked the kids. I didn't think that was cool. I was like, they don't need to be hit, you know, for every little thing. Mm-hmm. So that was like
boys
something.
Or girls?
Both. So we didn't agree on a lot of things. I'm more lenient. But you see, as parents, you're supposed to balance each other out.
Right.
So if you can, one person is the disciplinarian, you're like good cop, bad cop, mm-hmm. right? Mm. And that's how you run your household. I was okay with that. Like, okay. You know, to ask your father.
So you
know, like you ain't
want
to say no. So you like ask your father. Right, you know, right. I'm okay with that, but he wasn't okay with
being
you
the
know,
bad cop.
No, he was okay with it. He just wasn't okay with me not enforcing shit like he would.
Like
and
he
that
would,
just
okay.
is that's not me. You know, I let my kids do a lot. I just again and until they about to hurt themselves.
Mm. That's something different.
Then that's when I'm like, whoa, whoa, whoa. But they're like, we want Panera Bread. We want this. We want that.
So my question is this. Did you not pick him for that?
I did. I liked in the beginning. And then after a while,
so
you know,
his
the
fault,
ship. No, I'm a Gemini, so.
Y'all look crazy.
But this is what, and I've asked.
Gigi's a Gemini. This is how,
me asking these questions has helped me and Teyana so much, right? And I think I do a good job of sometimes not asking her, like, it'll be like when her friends are around and they having problems, and then mm-hmm. I ask them, but I'm like asking her two type of thing. Mm-hmm. But she understands what I'm trying to get at. You can't pick us.
And then try to change you. I agree with you absolutely.
But it's not, you're
not
changing.
You know who you married. You know who you married.
It's not a change, but it's not a change.
But you
got to grow. Yeah, yeah, you're going to grow. But it's one of the things where it's like certain things, it's like you have to remember, I like them for that.
Right.
Because at times we get trapped in a relationship and it's all about, how can I control that?
Right.
How can I control this part? Right. And it'll make me feel a little better. But when you get to the point where you're like, I got to realize that's what I got her for.
Right.
You know what I mean? Like, it's finna go down. Yeah, I want to knock this person out. He deserved this. I got to do this. And she like, nah. But no, that's going to make me look like a sucker. But I got her because she is the only person that can calm me down when I'm finna do something dumb.
That's good.
So it's like, at that moment, you know, I feel like women have that moment where they get mad at who they signed up for. Like,
but I wasn't mad at him for that. He was mad at me.
He
see, that's the part of the
you.
That's the part of the conversation that you
like
missed.
Him.
I was okay. Like, this is who you are, you know, and this is who I am. He didn't like who I was. He was never comfortable with who I was.
He thought you was gonna be down
I had
with
to
the
change for him. Like,
he thought you was gonna be helping
listen,
him.
Yeah, like that's not switch. Who I am.
He
like,
thought y'all was gonna whoop together.
Whipping or whatever it was.
Whole lot
like,
of ass whooping.
This is who you married. Like, this is who I am. And he didn't like that. He
got
felt
you. Damn,
like
player,
he had to
I was trying to help you out, player.
Well,
I was trying to help you out.
Let me ask you this. How important is sex in a marriage?
Very important.
So even if you guys aren't getting along, can the sex still be good?
Yes. But
that's
if you're not
usually,
having
that's
sex.
What make, that's usually what makes a relationship go longer than it's
sex.
Supposed to go.
But if you're not
if
having sex, see, you get to a point in your marriage a lot of time. I talk to married women all the time as you grow and years go by where sometimes your sex life slow down. But I think for me not knowing and not being in the place where I'm at now where I can, okay, you know what? It was wrong. When the sex stopped, I should have known he was going somewhere else.
Yeah. Mm. Habits.
That all you know, time. So, you know, you want to be on the couch. It's like, is it somebody else? Is it somebody else? Is it somebody else? Like, no. But yeah, like what you, I didn't put you on the couch. You put yourself on the couch. Mm-hmm. How you get down there? Oh, I was on the couch for months. I didn't put you down there. You walked down
see,
to the couch.
That couch shit, I wouldn't be with that couch shit.
You know?
Don't even though that's a, look at Iman, you be on the couch?
Hell no.
I know. Sleep on the couch.
But then, I didn't punish you to the couch.
Too,
you
I'm too
punished
large a
yourself.
Person to be trying to sleep on the couch. Top. Man, see, yeah. I would never.
That's but good, though,
if
because
anything, I'm going
so that's the sign. Like,
no matter how mad you are, you should be in bed together.
Me.
Yes, you should always want to go to bed together. You never, and I never wanted to go to bed mad. Like, you should always want to go to bed together. You know, like, it shouldn't be that deep where you punishing your couch.
And plus, when I'm mad, I want you to be in the bed next to me knowing that I'm mad.
True.
Yeah,
I'm
mad as hell. Like, don't touch me, but
I'm
you're still right
too.
Here.
Yeah,
nah,
but you're
I
still in the bed. Like, it's part marriage.
Scoot my
you go
butt
through
over.
Things, you know. You go through things.
I'm mad.
You're
gonna go.
That's how you really ain't mad. You ain't mad.
I'm
you
mad,
mad.
Fix this.
Yeah.
But I'd be mad, but I really will fall asleep.
Fix this.
I've never been that mad where I'm not scooting my butt.
You ever gave a mad blowjob? Like, you mad, but you still sucking his dick?
I might suck your dick better if I'm mad.
You not mad then. See, that's not real mad. That's play mad. That's like, mad.
No,
okay.
I suck dick better when I'm mad, when I'm in love, or when I'm drunk as fuck.
Passion.
That's anytime.
Okay.
Yeah,
and when I'm breathing.
And when I wake up.
And when I wake up.
That's the best time.
What?
If you ever want to take full control of a relationship, wake him up with that.
Oh, yeah. I know that trick.
If he wake, when you come in too, and it,
coming to because he was drugged.
I'm being raped with a mouth.
It feels like, no, it's, man, it's incredible. It's
have you
incredible.
Ever said no? Like, in the bedroom, have you ever been like, no, I don't feel like
it?
Because
you know, Gigi's a rapist.
Yeah, actually.
You have? No. Why would guys not feel like
that? She's going to be on me for this. She's going to be on me for this, but I'll give y'all a story. That's uh-oh. What y'all got me here for. I know.
Yeah,
Gigi.
Listen,
job.
He took control.
Oh, this your job?
No, make his drink. Make his drink.
He said, "Oh, this your job."
I didn't want to make it. Honestly, yeah.
Don't be shy.
Yeah, I'm not a. Yeah,
tell
I'm,
us this great
I'm
story.
I'm not drink. I'm not the drink maker man.
So let's hear about you telling story. Her no.
Oh yeah. So I had got mad at her for something. I don't remember what I got mad at, but I was mad as hell, and she She was, we was supposed to go out. She wanted me to go with her. I was like, no, it's cool or whatever, right? No, she didn't want me to go. She didn't want me to go. We got into it and she went. I was supposed to go somewhere else, but I cut my night short. I was tight. So I'm at the crib. She come back, hit. Try to wake me up out my, no, Joe, I'm not finna, because you're not about to do this. And every time
you're not gonna just go out and come
I was just talking about, man, you every time, as soon as you get back, you just gonna try and seduce me and then it's over with. No, it don't work like that. Yeah, that ain't how this works.
And then you did it.
Yeah, I gave it.
Yeah, of course you did.
Did you brush your teeth?
Photo, for sure though.
If you brush your teeth, it took a while.
For sure though.
Because I can't do that without brushing my teeth.
Man, it was.
So that was good. So you said that's good, though, when you're mad, the angry.
Yeah, but that's what I'm saying. Here, angry sex.
Yeah, angry is really good.
All sex is good.
Anything is good.
Yeah, it's good.
As long as we're having sex, it's good.
Well, gotta be.
Us dudes is simple like that. We go to work.
That's how I've heard.
You cook and you, that's it. You drain us, that's it.
You what drain we? Us.
You drain me, I'm good.
You drain us.
You drain us.
That's what guys really say. You drain us.
Yeah, we want
to. I don't mind getting drained. Drain me.
What about if that happens before you got to play?
What?
Like having sex before you got to play, does that make you?
As long as I get a good nap, I'm sure.
But what if you don't have time for a nap? What if it's right before?
Then I can't do it.
Really? You'll
no,
say no.
I got rules and regulations.
I've heard that before from boxers.
Yeah. That's not the only thing. That's like the only thing I can't, like, certain. That's when you can't bend the rules. Like with basketball, that's the only thing that'll, like, I can't, like, just for like music or something, like before a show. Like, nope, no
who
rules.
Cares, right? Yeah.
No rules. I can just go out there and tell them, honestly, guys, Teyana drained me. I'm tired tonight. I'm gonna give y'all a show, but I'm tired tonight.
It's gonna be a lazy ass show. Y'all put your hands together for
y'all
10 minutes.
Y'all be lazy with me. Y'all be lazy with me tonight, man.
So if you have a bad game, we know why.
Nah, that's what I'm saying. You'll never. I'm not breaking my routine. That's a serious thing.
Yeah.
But
like
she know about
playbook,
that. Like
right.
She been
she
with me for years now. Yeah, she know what it is. She know the cutoff.
She like after the game.
She know when I'm gonna be asleep. She know.
Did she used to try in the beginning to break your rules though? Like fuck this rule.
No, we big on each other's careers. We ain't gonna violate each other's careers.
Because when she got to perform, she probably can't do that because her performances be.
No, I'm saying she's better at juggling and recreating shit. Like she don't. Her schedule can change. Her routine can change.
Plus, girls are better at having sex and being able to like function after.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
I feel like men can't function as well after sex as women can.
No, guys die.
We not trying to do that.
Because like, we have sex, we get.
Listen,
we clean the house.
First
we
have sex, y'all fall asleep, they have to die. Anything, if we have to do something, we'll get it done.
Nah, I've
but you're not gonna
it.
Be
but
doing it the
what
way
you try to get. What you gotta get is we not trying to do nothing. So afterwards, we are trying to go to sleep. Yes, because
exactly.
This is the best option right now.
But for women, when we have sex, I don't.
But
I
if
mean,
I
like,
had to
do
something, I could do it. I
gotta go to lip service. Bye. No, I'm just
earlier today.
Yeah, exactly. I had to get it together. Oh, no, I'm joking.
She wet wipe. Don't worry.
No, that's nasty. I gotta get in the shower. I don't play that to have sex and just wipe and leave.
Like, I like when guys, after I have sex, they don't take a shower. I like when my man doesn't take a shower and just goes.
I'm talking about me. He's not taking a shower.
I have to take a shower, but I like it. I prefer if he doesn't take a shower.
He'll stick that dick in another pussy with your
scent. No, he won't.
You got shit fucked
Wasn't
up.
Wasn't it Jill Scott? Raheem?
Keep it on it. Right. Raheem will be really quick. He might have a condom on still. Fucked up.
I like him to not shower and just go
back. That's a young Joe.
Young Joe.
Yeah. If he takes a shower, I'm like, what are you doing?
Oh, you about to go on a date, nigga. You taking a shower.
So you showering now?
Oh, so what you start taking
shower? What we doing?
Now this nigga want a shower. Fuck
out. You better take this hot rag and keep it moving.
Now, that's a bad. If he take a shower, he cheating on you, sis.
The hot rag.
You take this hot rag.
Look, hot rag going a long way.
A bird bath.
Niggas are lazy. He take a shower.
A hot rag
go
a long way. You hear me? You and me. Listen, yeah, you get that hot rag, keep the air compacted.
No. Keep it warm like you do at the nail salon.
And if he doesn't do a good job, bring him a cold rag.
Damn.
Nah, yeah. That's gone. You're gone too far.
You're gone cold too rag far. And put it right down. Plop.
That's when a bitch would probably get punched in her eye because of shit. You got a nigga ice cold rag.
Ice cold.
Don't worry, baby. Put your hands back. I got it for you.
Oh my God. Y'all gross.
We're gross.
I want everybody to know listening in. I know all of y'all are disgusting for listening to this collection of females, man.
Well, Iman Shumpert, we thank you so much for coming through. Substance Abuse is out now.
Yes,
are we getting season two? Yes.
Of
your show with Teyana.
I'm saying we dabble in a lot, baby. Mm-hmm. Okay.
Oh, okay.
You know what I'm saying? We got a lot going on.
We got a lot going on.
Clothing line coming.
Oh,
yeah.
We got the nail salon.
She got the nail salon if y'all need y'all nails done. Mm-hmm. I got to plug a lot right now.
I've been saying I'm going to Harlem.
You see these, you got to look at these.
We need to take a
look
trip.
Look at my Reebok. I rode all of them.
Gave my wife a big bag.
I thought she was about to say something else.
No.
A big what? A big.
I'm playing off a Reebok, so it's saying quotation. Reebok pairing my wife.
Oh, that's
but it's me joking around just writing on, you know, she with Reebok. I ain't got to
I got my Teyana Taylor Reeboks. The
you
red
do?
Ones.
Okay,
yes,
that's
I
what I was saying. Very making cute. Sure I plugged it out. You know what I mean? Like, you know, I got supposed to be coming, you know, some clothing, some upscale clothing for y'all. I made it for men, but it's unisex because I like when my girl wear oversized stuff.
Right.
So I got some.
Now I'm a lip service.
You know,
vet. Yeah.
I'm a vet already.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. That's all it takes.
Damn.
You came out here one time.
Congratulations. Yeah. Well,
you
now that I'm a
service.
Vet. Yeah.
Listen.
Yeah. I gotta get y'all some clothes, man.
Yeah, please.
For sure though, y'all gotta have like my shit on like a mannequin every time y'all film.
A mannequin.
You know we have mannequins in our house.
We gonna be the mannequin.
No, for sure though. But I'm saying
I love oversized clothes. Back.
Of course. Of course.
Leave now.
I guess, man. But yeah. Tough. Y'all go to Junie
you just
B's.
Talking to me?
No. Y'all go to Junie B's, get your nails done, man.
Well,
we got an eyewear store too. If y'all need some sunglasses, if you need prescription, anything you need, we got it over here. You know what I'm saying? What else we got going on? I'm missing anything? Fade to fit, sign up,
fade
lose some
fade,
weight.
Yep.
You know, snatch your waist.
Snatch.
You see, we
Can
got
we
the clothes
dance
coming.
Like Teyana on
Teyana gonna teach you how to dance, baby. But it's either you got it or you don't.
Oh, right.
She gonna teach you the numbers, but it's you
five,
know what
six,
I'm saying.
Seven, eight.
I don't
see girls. See, girls, they be DMing me. Oh, so I'ma look just like her. I don't know, baby. No. Your palette a little different.
Gigi, but. You and Teyana need to, you know,
that would be dope.
Because Gigi is an incredible dancer.
That's what I'm saying. So come fade to fit it.
Fade to fit.
You
that,
know
that
what I'm saying?
Actually might be a good you okay. and Teyana lip that service. Fit, yeah.
That's what I'm saying. Y'all, like, you really
nah?
You really supposed to come do fade to fit too?
And it's in Harlem. I will.
No, ain't no out.
We all going.
We gonna lip service an episode. I can get it set up.
Yeah, let's do it.
Okay, that's what I'm just trying to plug everything that we got going on right now.
Now he's our PR. You got all
PR and all that. So search Iman.
Listen,
Iman.
Teyana ain't the only one know how to juggle. You up here juggling?
There we go.
You know what I'm saying? I'm getting better. That's the part of the relationship, the growth.
I'm waiting for the clothing line. I think the clothing
with
line
the
is
R,
so fire.
Growth. Yeah, we got a lot to plug. We got anything else to plug before I forget?
Anything else?
Yeah, that's
he's
it.
He's on it. What was that?
My brother cut hair if y'all what need this? Y'all haircut. Hey, Trouble.
You went like this. What's
Trouble,
that?
Where you dropping social media? I don't know when trouble dropping social media. We waiting on it like we waiting on the detox. But that's all we need right now, man.
Now the detox came out.
No, it didn't.
It didn't?
No, oh. It's okay, though, baby.
Oh, my God.
We still rock with you, baby.
What did he put out, though? Compton. No, it's cool. Sorry.
Laria, finish your drink, damn it.
Right.
Finish your drink.
And I'm really proud of you. I'm proud of you for these Louis Boosts, though. I told you that before. I'm going to tell you that again.
Thank you.
If y'all haven't already.
Why you got your shoes off?
He been off since we came up here.
I know.
He got the shoes off. Chicken.
You got nice feet.
Listen, he's been the most comfortable.
No, I need to go to Junie Beach to get my nails done right now. No, for real. Like, if you see my manicure coming up, you see the clear coming off of there?
Yeah, I see.
Haven't got them done since last time I was at Junie Beach. I just cut
That's the only place you go.
I cut. Yeah.
Because we can't get no picture of you nowhere else.
I'm getting a nail next time. They do a nail that has my daughter on it.
I'm about to get on my phone for sure though. All right, Iman Shumpert, you can't abuse too much of a good thing.
Exactly, substance abuse. Now you get it. That's what I'm saying, man. Now you in show. Y'all play my shit, man.
DJ Gigi.
I am not the DJ.
I'm the bartender. I'm gonna tell Envy.
Angela's the DJ. I'm the bartender.
Tell this light skinned ass to play this substance abuse.
We gonna
man.
Tell
this
little beige Envy to play.
Tell them I ain't tripping off their ass no more. Him and,
oh, you not?
Him and Lil Dark. Yeah.
Oh, God.
Him and Lil Dark. Lil Dark, man. They cool, man. I seen Lil Charlamagne at.
Lil Charlamagne.
Yeah. What you call it? I seen Buddy at the red carpet for when T won the dance award, though. The shit I got her flowers for because she was tweaking. Yes.
Well, him and Teyana have a good relationship.
No, that's why I dropped it, though, because I was like, you know what, G? Anybody that paint my wife in a good life, I got to, you know what I'm saying? I got to give you some love, because it was a time that people wasn't rocking with my wife.
Right.
Mars was low-key pissing me off like she wasn't doing what she was doing, and nobody was giving her no credit for nothing.
Mm-hmm.
They would only post bad stuff about her all the time. Nobody would post the good stuff. So it's like, it was a time that all that was going on, and Charlamagne still was looking out for her. He was saying, and that's what gave him points with me. I really didn't care about the
beef. Yeah, who cares what he says about you?
No. When he said it, he don't know what he did. He low-key got me some clicks.
Okay.
On the low, he kind of glowed me up. On the low, and I ain't understand that till later on. He kind of put a little light on me, and I feel like he kind of knew that I was going to keep working at it. He knew I wasn't going to stop rapping.
Mm-hmm.
But it was like, the better I got, like, more people started, like, knowing. Just because he said what he said.
Because he said something.
It was crazy. Like, I don't even think he meant to do that. Maybe he did, maybe he didn't.
You think he strategically planned that he's going to get more clicks if I say something?
No, not that. I just, it was like I said about the situation. Mm-hmm. With the rumors and shit. If I say something about it, it becomes real.
Right.
He could have just been like, I don't know who y'all talking about. Like, he could have just never, ever said nothing about me ever. He could have never judged it.
We had a whole interview with Teyana that we ended up not playing.
She tried it.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, he tried it, and he thought she wasn't going to say something. But that's what I'm saying. Even with all of that. Cool. She told me about that. She told me she shut it down. She said they didn't post it out, whatever. I said, cool. But it was one of them things where it's like, As long as me and Charlamagne shit is me and Charlamagne shit, and me and DJ Envy shit is me and DJ Envy shit, and then they relationship with Teyana straight, then I can't be a bogus nigga. You know what I'm saying? Like, I can't be bogus. So I can't be bogus even now, because it's like, at the end of the day, now that I think about it, it was good publicity for people to click on my music.
At the time, you was mad, but then when you look back, you like...
As I look back on it, because I got older. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? I was in New York. I was,
And it ain't stop you?
It ain't stop nothing.
Right.
That's what I'm saying. It actually helped me.
Mm-hmm.
That's what's crazy. So it's like, you know, I ain't tripping no more. You know what I mean? Now, if I ever saw the interview where he was saying something, I'm going to have something to say about it. For sure, though, because y'all know how I am. But I'm fair. I'm very fair. You know what I'm saying? I'm very fair. And when I saw him at the award show, he didn't have nothing crazy to say, nothing. He said, beautiful family. We shook hands and we kept it moving. You know what I'm saying? Like, it wasn't no bad blood. And I could respect that from a man. You know what I mean? Like, I could respect that. I ain't tripping. You know what I mean? I ain't gonna, you know.
We know.
I could have shoot up the club, so hey, you know what I'm saying?
Right, because you got too much going on anyway, so who gives a shit?
I ain't do nothing.
Shit popping.
I ain't do nothing.
I'm just quiet.
You know what I mean? Yeah. Look, she's like, I'm quiet. I ain't saying nothing. But bump all that. Tell the light skinned and tell Lil Charlamagne to go ahead and play. Huh?
9 a.m. Charlamagne just texted me.
What? This is a great thing.
He'll be fine. Okay. Yeah, he'll be fine.
Yeah, he talks shit all the time. That's what I'm saying. When he talks shit, everybody like, yeah, it's just Charlamagne. Don't take it personal. Then I say something, I'm like, hey, man, don't blow it, man. He gonna interview you finally, bro. Like, no, I ain't tripping. I don't think he cares that much, though.
He don't care.
You know what I'm saying? I think he sort of knows, bro, because I told you, yeah.
Everybody got a problem with something he says, so he
was cool, like, at the end of the day. He's trolling people too. He know I can't take a swing at him. I ain't finna be on no bogus shit.
And we don't want to see you in no rap beef either. We were talking about Tekashi and all this stuff going on with him and Chief Keef and.
Oh, it's true. I don't want no. I hope not. I hope that boy stay far away from Chicago. I hope they squash this, bro. I'm scared for him.
Who, Tekashi?
Tekashi, yeah. Nah, I'm scared for him. That don't prove that. I don't want him. If this get out before he go, you don't have to prove no point to none of us on this earth, bro. Don't go to Chicago with that, bro. What I mean? Right. I understand what everybody got going on. I understand the clout. I understand people is strong and strength in numbers. Boy, they don't care in Chicago. They ain't got no order right now. Mm-hmm. The little homies is not listening to the big homies. They'll do it just to say they did it. And I don't want nobody else getting in trouble. I don't want no more violence, Joe. It's entertaining, but the clicking on Chicago to pick that place to joke about, Joe, they out. Yeah, come on, bro. You
this
pulling.
This is real life.
This is right. For real. I don't know about the other stuff because I'm not from there. It may be somebody else that could verify what's real and fake going on everywhere else. This Chicago stuff that they got going on, I know too many people. You know what I mean? It's like, Joe, just, all right, can y'all stay out of this, bro? I'm calling, bro, to stay out of it, bro. Please, leave him, let him go.
What if somebody came?
Y'all don't even want to be in Chicago right now anyway. Stay y'all ass in Atlanta. Stay everywhere else, but leave. Let him go. Let him do whatever he want to do.
Just, I feel like he squashes his beefs. Like, I feel like he gets him.
There's
beef,
no squashing.
And then he squashes.
Listen.
That's what they said about the last 8 people he was beefing with.
The last 8 rappers, right?
Uh-huh. I mean,
he's
shoot at somebody?
He's picking Chicago.
Else? He shot at a couple people, right?
Man, this man talk
supposedly
about F Chicago,
I don't know shit about none of
bro.
Let's be clear. I don't know none of y'all niggas.
That's what I'm saying. I just want that man to realize that everybody ain't for the entertainment
stuff.
Yeah,
it's not all.
They not all trying to get clicks. Some people really don't want to be known. They really don't want to be seen. They really don't. They really trying to do that. Like, don't invite
them. They're not
that.
Trying to be celebrities.
Because I seen him. Like, he's a good little kid. You know what I mean? Like, he's smart with the mark, and I understand he won this way, but it's like, bro, you going a little
too far.
Yeah. But me and Charlamagne ain't gonna ever go there to.
No, I'm about to say that.
I'm not going.
I know that's not gonna happen.
Everybody else, which one would you be?
Oh, I'm the quiet one. Oh yeah. I'm
so Charlamagne's Tekashi.
I mean, he would have in that sense.
I think it's the hair.
He has the radio. Yeah, you know the radio platform. Okay. No, it's cool. No, I really want. What is he saying about it? He's probably making a joke of it, huh?
No, nothing.
Or has he warned him?
We actually had Tekashi on the Breakfast Club.
Did he warn him?
He was really good on there.
Did he warn him though? Oh, that's what I said.
I like that kid. I don't know.
That's what I'm saying.
I like Tekashi.
But I don't like the rant. If you have beef with somebody, if there's legitimate problems, okay. But this random picking with people.
Yeah, I don't know what
it's like a marketing plan. Yeah. And it's not
still working for him this far, but now it might be
going
too far.
Yeah, I just don't. I don't know. I don't know. I thought, because the other stuff seemed calculated. You know, being a blood. Going to LA and the Bloods and Crips, and you could squash all that because everything's under the same umbrella.
Right.
And then you just throw random Chicago in there.
That was weird. Yeah,
you done took it too far.
You gone too far.
I just don't know, bro. I don't know. I've just, from what I've seen, I don't want, no. Just squash that if y'all can. Anybody squash that, please just squash that.
I don't
see
Chief Keef squashing it.
I hope he do, man. He don't need to be in trouble.
He don't seem like a squasher.
He ain't part of it. He ain't a part of it, Joe. Okay.
I seen that on TMZ.
Yeah, he said it. That's why as soon as they shot, whatever they did, Joe, he got out of there good. He doing right. Mm-hmm. Run away, Joe, and stay away. Stay out the way. Just take your radio streams that whatever happened from this publicity.
Yeah, so they gained him a lot.
You gained some streams. Cool. Just stay out of trouble, bro. We don't want you in trouble.
because this is getting crazy.
Yeah.
This is getting crazy.
This is what
I don't want him to be Tupac for him to be Ro. That's going to piss me off if we put him up here with greats because he get popped or something. Like,
I mean, he only
I don't want that to be his story,
too.
Though.
Yeah, he has one project.
I think part of the issue is that
social
media and things going viral.
They gassing
doing all kinds of things. Like, when Tupac was around, he was
But you know,
doing
people
stuff,
do that. They give you a certain platform once you pass. Like, I watched it happen with Fredo. Like, Fredo passed, and he was trying to educate people while he going through it. He trying to educate people, get off this drink. Stop drinking this. Like, just care about your health. Do all this. And then he the one that passed. So it's like, with everything that's going on, like, when people get that platform, it's like, you kind of like, I get what you did to get up here, dog, but now use it for something else, bro.
Right.
Like, you did your marketing scheme. It worked. You here. Everything you do, you touch is platinum. Just now, go on the right track now. Yeah. Just, you got it. Just, I don't want him venturing over here and then it taking this to happen and it'd be like, oh, but if he, then it'd be the conversation of, oh, but he would have been a better musician than this guy if they wouldn't have killed him. But it's like, he went picking for people.
Right. Do you think that, like, what if he wanted to do a song with you? Do you have to be cautious of, like, I don't want to co-sign?
That's what I'm saying. I wouldn't be able to at this point. Mm-hmm. You've been into it with so many.
I feel like you could do the song, but you can't go performing with that nigga now and he got to send you his files.
What's the point in doing a song with him? If I did a song with Tekashi, it would be because I want to be a part of that energy that you bring. Right. So I want to perform this. I want to have that excitement and that energy with you.
But you also don't want to get shot.
You got rainbow hair and you be throwing your hair around with water all in it. I'm not finna do all that. But I steal that energy.
With water all in
it. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. I steal that energy if we on a stage. You know what I mean? And it's like, I feel like that's what excites people about wanting to do a collab with him. But you got people probably now that's tiptoeing around it. Like, I don't know.
I don't want to die.
I don't be caught up in all that.
I don't know what's real, what's fake. What if I'm at the studio you at and they come for you then?
But like you said, that's the crazy part. We don't know what's real or what's fake. We don't know what's not going to happen or who's going to stop beefing with. Or because it's so weird. One week you got real live beef. We're going to kill each other. And then the next week, y'all cool.
On stage together.
On stage performing
know.
Together.
I don't know what's confused. Real. I hope it's all fake.
I'm too old
I just know what's coming. I just know what's coming out of that 773-708-312. Now I don't want none of that to enter none of this rap stuff.
I thought you was giving your phone number out.
No. That's the area code. That's Chicago code.
Yeah, I figured that out.
But it's like you. They for real.
Mm-hmm. Right.
Like, this ain't like the internet gangbanging thing. I get the terminology. Everything becomes more public because, like I remember the first time hearing phonem from people that don't have any attachment to what that is. Mm-hmm. And it's like, it's become, even a rapper saying it, it could be the tag phrase that get that rapper on. So they now giving people a pass to say stuff that people say in the street.
Right.
So it becomes like people don't have a care for it. But when you start seeing people violate it and just take advantage of it, it's like, at some point, y'all gotta know that there's gonna be repercussions to this.
Mm-hmm.
Like, people say certain stuff because people really die. People really have things going on. Like, I don't had to pay for half the funerals. Like,
right.
Like, you can't joke around.
It ain't no joke
it.
To you, right?
Yeah, it ain't a joke. Like, a lot of this stuff happens and it go on behind the scenes. And then it's like, y'all are just violating, disrespect someone, don't know what's going on, don't care about what's going on, and you think there's no repercussions for it. But because I know, it's just like, this is the one, I don't like this move.
Right.
I don't know about the other car pulling. I'll admit I was entertained by it. All the car pulling that was going on, I thought it was funny. I laughed. I clicked on all of it. I didn't like it because I didn't want to pick a side on anybody.
Right.
I'm not going to do that. I know too many people.
Like,
my wife
like
know
this?
Too many. Yeah, my wife know too many people. She got to do records with people. I don't want to entertain no bad blood. But now this is, I don't even want to click on this no more. This about, I don't like how this shaping out, brother.
All right.
All right.
All right.
Well, so, yeah, like, that's what I'm saying. Yeah. If we can,
let's end all the beef. Let's support all, you know, all the people we can support, man. Keep spreading the love, man.
Positivity.
Yeah, some positivity before we get off of this junk.
No y'all, more black on
y'all
black.
Y'all gave me
black
a positive, nice
crime.
Henny and lemonade mix. I appreciate the concoction.
There we go. Hey.
You already know.
Cheers. Nice. Thank you for coming.
Thank you, Engine Room
shump,
Audio.
Shump, shump, shump.
I forgot to plug Engine Room Audio. I got that.
Hey.
They mastered his album here.
Yeah, yeah, there we go.
Yeah, they mastered my substance abuse project. I did not know that till I got here, but everything happens for a reason.
You didn't say lip service.
Right, you ain't say lip service.
Lip service.
Lip service. Okay.